Somebody got shot. I need paramedics here now. Somebody got shot. I need paramedics
somebody
here
got
now.
Shot.
Now at the house meeting. Somebody got shot in the neck. I need paramedics here now.
That's the voice of Barbara Betancourt's best friend. Frightened, not sure what to do, not even sure what just happened. This is the first time we're playing this 911 call for you. It's part of the evidence the CBS 12 News I-team uncovered. The best friend told police she went with Barbara to Barbara's ex-boyfriend's apartment. The two of them went into a bedroom while she waited in another room. Then there was the sound of a gunshot. Who pulled the trigger? Unknown.
I'm going to jail.
If you couldn't make that out, that's a young man telling the dispatcher, I'm going to jail. And that's the voice of Barbara's ex-boyfriend.
It's frustrating.
Barbara's loved ones are still confused about that reaction. They're asking, does it make sense to say that if she had accidentally shot herself?
If they're going to say it was an accident, show me the proof. Show me exactly how she did it.
Well, there's always going to be questions. Again, it's a teenager who lost their life tragically. Nobody's ever going to want to accept it was an accident.
The Palm Springs Police Department believes that the evidence supports the ex-boyfriend's explanation of the incident. And his version goes like this. They skipped school, his parents weren't home, so he and Barbara had sex. Afterwards, Barbara asked to see the gun that he bought on the internet. While she was handling it, he says she accidentally shot herself. But what does he do next? In this interview with police, he said he freaked out and threw the gun out of a window. The Palm Springs Police Department brought in a consultant, a ballistics expert, who police say agreed with their findings. But we have his report, which is inconclusive. Here he writes, I cannot rule out a self-inflicted gunshot wound. He doesn't even address if it could have been a homicide.
He can't tell you who fired the gun. He can't tell you whether it was suicide or whether it was homicide. And so that's the greater issue.
Dr. David Thomas is a former Gainesville police officer, now forensic expert and professor at Florida Gulf Coast University. The I-team brought him the case materials, and in his opinion, investigators may have skipped important steps. When you look at what we do have here, the narrative, the ballistics report, the summary of the case, the 911 call, are you convinced, or do you feel like there's some doubt here that this could have been a homicide?
I think there's some doubt. The big thing is the evidence or the failure to collect evidence. To me, that's huge.
Dr. Thomas wants to know why police didn't look for blood spatter on the ex-boyfriend's clothes, plus gunshot residue. Dr. Thomas says everyone's hands should have been tested.
I respect his opinion. I have to respect the outside person that we talk to. I have to respect our investigators.
Edgar Morley, spokesperson for Palm Springs Police, says the department doesn't do gunshot residue testing. One reason, he says, in an enclosed space, gunshot residue could end up on everyone's hands.
You have to go wherever the evidence takes you, and they're not allowing that. It almost seems like they're trying to take the evidence and let it fit the narrative.
A year and a half after Barbara's death, her ex-boyfriend is set to appear in juvenile court this week, charged with illegal possession of a firearm and evidence tampering. And now, the CBS 12 News I-team has learned prosecutors just added another charge, culpable negligence, for carelessly introducing a gun to that environment.
They're trying to place some responsibility on the team. We think it's significant.